Good morning, children. Today, we will revise continuously main topics of chapter 2. First topic is mechanical energy. Mechanical energy is of two forms, potential energy and kinetic energy. So, mechanical energy can be defined as the energy possessed by body by the virtue of change in size, shape, structure of the body and state of motion or rest of the body. State of rest or motion of the body. Mechanical energy has two forms, potential energy and kinetic energy. Potential energy of a body is due to change in size, shape and structure of the body. So, potential energy is equal to mgh. M is mass, g is acceleration due to gravity and h is height above the surface of the earth. Some example of potential energy is raised hammer, wound, key of toy or watch, a stretched or compressed spring, etc. Kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is due to change in speed or change in speed of the body or velocity of the body or rest of the body. Rest of the body. So, a state of change in a state of change of rest or motion of the body. Kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. M is mass and v is velocity of the body. Kinetic energy depends on two factors, mass and velocity. Kinetic energy is directly proportional to a square of velocity. If velocity of the body is doubled, then its kinetic energy becomes 4 times. When velocity becomes 3 times, then kinetic energy will become 9 times. When velocity becomes 4 times, then kinetic energy will become 16 times. Why? Because kinetic energy is directly proportional to a square of velocity. Expression of kinetic energy. Let us consider a body moving with velocity v. An opposite force is acted on the body and body stops after covering a distance s. And uniform retardation be A. Uniform retardation of the body be A. Then retarding force F is equal to mass into acceleration MA. This is equation number 1. And kinetic energy of the body is equal to work done by retarding force. So F into S, F is retarding force and S is distance covered by body. Distance covered by body. By linear equation of motion. Linear equation of motion. By linear equation of motion, we know that V square is equal to U square plus 2S. U is initial velocity and V is final velocity. And 2AS, A uniform retardation, S distance. So, final velocity is 0, initial velocity is V and retardation A is equal to minus A. So, 0 square is equal to B square minus 2AS. So, 2AS is equal to B square, S is equal to B square by 2A. This is equation number 3. Using first and third in equation 2. So, kinetic energy K is equal to F is equal to MA and S is equal to B square by 2S. So, 2A and A cancel. So, this will become K is equal to half MB square. This is the expression of kinetic energy. This is the expression of kinetic energy. K is equal to half MB square. M is mass of the body and B is velocity of the body. Now, relation between kinetic energy, K and momentum. Relation between kinetic energy and momentum. Kinetic energy, we know that kinetic energy is equal to K is equal to half mb square, where m is mass of the body and v is velocity of the body. And momentum, P is equal to mb, m mass of the body and v velocity of the body. So, squaring on both sides, this will become P square is equal to m square by v square. Now, find v square. So, you can write v square is equal to P square by m square. P square by m square. Using v square in equation 1. So, you can write K is equal to half M V square is equal to P square by M square. Single M and single M cancel. This will become K is equal to P square by 2M. This can be written P square is equal to 2MK by crossing. And P is equal to root under 2MK. So, this is the relation. This is the relation between kinetic energy, K and momentum. P is equal to root under 2MK. Work energy theorem. According to work energy theorem, the work done by a force on a moving body is equal to the increase in its kinetic energy. That is, W is equal to kinetic energy final minus kinetic energy initial. Final velocity V and initial velocity U. So, kinetic energy final is equal to half MB square and kinetic energy initial is equal to half MU square. So, W is equal to half MB square minus half MU square. This means that work done by force on moving body is equal to increase in kinetic energy. Conservation of energy. Conservation of energy. Very important topic. Conservation of energy. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It can be transferred from one form to another form. One form to another form. But total energy at any point or any time, be conserved. in the system. And this is called conservation of energy. This is called conservation of energy. Verification of conservation of energy. In case of freely falling body. Consider a body is falling from A to B, B to C. A is the maximum height of the body and B is intermediate between maximum height and from ground. And C is the ground surface, earth surface of the earth surface. So A is the maximum height of the body. So maximum height of the body from the ground is x plus y and there velocity is zero. Velocity is zero, so kinetic energy is zero and potential energy is equal to mgh. Potential energy is equal to mg into x plus y. Mg into x plus y. So mgx plus mgy. So total energy at A will be potential energy plus kinetic energy, and kinetic energy is zero and potential energy is mgh plus mgy. This is number one. At B, distance covered by body while falling from A to B, this is x, and initial velocity of the body is zero and final velocity is v. And distance of the body at B from the ground is y, written in the figure. So potential energy is equal to mgh, and h is y. Mg mgy, and v square is equal to u square plus 2as, and final velocity v square, initial velocity 0 and 2g and s is equal to x. So v square is equal to 2gx. So kinetic energy is equal to half mv square, and v square is equal to 2gx. 2 cancel, this will be mg x. Total energy at B will be potential energy plus kinetic energy, mgx plus mgy. This is equation number 3. Now, at C, that is on the ground. So, distance covered while falling the body from A to C will be x plus y. Final velocity v1 is equal to b, and initial velocity is 0. Potential energy is equal to mgh, h is equal to 0 because body reaches to the ground. So mg into 0, potential energy will be 0. And kinetic energy, V1 square is equal to U square plus 2AS. V1 is equal to V. V square is equal to 0 square plus 2G. And S is X plus Y. So V square is equal to 2G X plus Y. Now kinetic energy, half MV square. V square is equal to 2G X plus Y. 2 cancel. MG x plus y, so mgx plus mgy. First, second and third. This is third. From first, second and third, we have seen kinetic energy. This is. And total energy. And total energy is equal to mgx plus mgy. This is number third. 1, 2 and 3, we have seen that x kinetic energy, total energy at A is equal to mb, and C is equal to mgx plus mgy. So you can write from first, second and third. It is verified that energy is conserved in a freely falling body. So, in a freely falling body, there is no any force acting on the body except earth. Then, at any point or at every point of a freely falling body, the energy will be conserved.